Hey, I'm Brian Van, SportbikeTrackGear.com. Today we're going to show you how to remove and reinstall the OEM bodywork on our 2022 STG Yamaha R7 project bike. Okay, we're gonna open this segment up with tools that we used. Got a 5mm T-handle, 4mm T-handle. Got a 4mm ball type, and this isn't a must-have, but if you have it, it's helpful in a couple of spots. Ball type Allen wrench, 4mm. Quarter inch drive ratchet. Small pick. Flat bladed screwdriver. This is, you know, everyone has that. Not a big deal. This is a little trim clip tool. If you don't have that, don't panic. You can use a screwdriver to do that. Stubby Phillips head. Got a T-handle with a 10mm socket. Got good news for you. We got lav mics on the way, man. It's gonna take out all this echo, but they didn't show up, right? Welcome to the coronapocalypse. This is gonna be one of the longest videos that we're going to shoot. This will serve as a baseline for all you R7 owners that are looking to do either maintenance or projects on your own motorcycle. In this video, I'm gonna show you step by step what it takes to remove every individual piece and reinstall it on the R7. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come in down here, and there are two little push pins to release. You push in on the center, and you'll hear it release, a little click. Go ahead and slide those out like so. Then there are more plastic clips in here that we need to get in and remove. And these are the Phillips types. These can be tricky sometimes. I've already done this one time, so I was able to get all these out. Some of the tight access points, you know, we can only show you guys so much. We apologize for that, but you know, I do have to be able to actually do the project. You can kind of hear this thing releasing, re-engaging. I'm gonna take three of these out on both sides. I'll switch sides. Some of this is like watching paint dry too, you know. It's like, oh, look at what a pain in the ass that clip is. Look how long that took. But that's just the reality of it. And this video will be one of the most important ones that we'll probably shoot. Because when you're working on your own bike, one of the biggest challenges can be that OEM bodywork, man. It can be really tough. Especially if you don't have the experience of working on several different models. Some of the stuff's pretty brittle too. You know, a good rule of thumb is if you have to put too much pressure on it, it's probably got another bolt that you need to look for. So we have all those out, and I'm gonna come back over to the other side. So that was a total of 8 plastic clips. 6 of which had the Phillips center, 2 of which had the circular center that you push in to release. Next panel we're going to remove is going to be this piece right here. There's a fastener back here, it has a 4mm internal hex. There's another one here that has a 4mm internal hex. What I like to do is I like to try and leave the fasteners on the side of the bike they're being removed from. Pay close attention and don't be afraid to take a couple of pictures. You know, if you're like, man, I don't know if I'm gonna be able to remember where all these fasteners go. Everybody's got a smartphone. Go ahead and pull that bad boy out of your pocket and start snapping pics. Down here, there is going to be a plastic clip that pushes through a rubber grommet. You want to go ahead and kind of support this and pull out like so. Once you've done that, support this upper fairing and kind of put your thumb here, pull out. You can see the locator clips, they are pretty robust. There's a small locator pin up here in the front. That is probably going to be the most vulnerable one. And then right here is that plastic clip that went through this grommet right here. Make sure you lay your fairings down in a spot where somebody's not going to come out in the garage and trample them to death. I picked this bike up from my buddy Gary Virgin over at Evansville Superbike Shop in Indiana. Gary's a good dude, racer, been around a long time. Real nice shop over there. If you happen to be local to Gary or regional, I think that's a dealer that is worth shopping at for sure. Those are all four internal hex. Remember, we have that push pin that's through the grommet down here. Release that. Same thing here, a little pressure on your thumb. Pull this panel out. Off it comes. Here we have a 10 mil hex. Set that over here. Four mil internal hex. So the top hat spacer came out with that. See the other one right here. Off comes that panel. All right, when we come back, we're going to lower the bike down and begin disassembling some of the pieces up top. Okay, now we're gonna start working back here on the tail. Grab your ignition key. You wanna slide it into your passenger seat, disengage that. Go ahead and put that off to the side. This will help you get your rider seat off too, get you access to your battery. A couple little push pins back here. Go ahead and release those. This panel, pull out and up at the same time. Off it comes. Your seat, your rider seat is held on by these 2 5 mil internal hex fasteners right here. If you need to get access to your battery, this is how you would do that. Pretty simple procedure. Pull up and back. You can see there's the rest of your toolkit. There's an Allen back here. There's a tongue right here on the subframe bracket that engages with the seat pan itself. That is how the seat is held in up front, and then of course back here with the bolts. Tail section is what we're gonna work on here next. We've got a combination of many, many pieces, right? So we're gonna get these side panels off and then move backwards to the tail section itself. For these side panels, we've got a 10 mil hex. Both sides, you have a couple of pins. There's one over here. And then there is one down low too. And I want to lift the table up just for this one, but it is right here. You have one on either side. I'll grab the other one here on the other side. This is always hardest the first couple times. You know, it's like we go to the track, Max's Ninja 400 that he's been racing at Moto America. I've had that bike apart so many times now. I could be sleeping and get that bike apart and put it back together. Got a 4mm internal hex here. There's the length. One up front as well. Give an idea what those look like. To remove this panel, need to reach in here and kind of pull outward. I'll show you what we have holding it on. There's a grommet here, here, and here. And you can see the clips right there. It's also important to note that this has to dip in under the frame right here, okay? So we'll go over to the other side, remove this panel. Off she comes. Now we'll focus on the tail. The tail is a modular piece, right? We're gonna raise it up right now. So underneath, you have a total of 7 fasteners, and they're the style where you just push it on the center. This panel, once I remove this last one here, is actually going to come off, like so. That bad boy to the side. Got one more right here. All right. When we come back, we're going to be taking the two halves off the tail section. Okay, so back here you have this single 4mm internal hex. There's your length. Slide up and back. Put that panel to the side. You have one fastener right here. You have 4 here. Important to note, these have a spacer that you want to make sure you do not lose. I'll show you that when we get it out. Right there. That prevents the plastic from being crushed by the fastener. Very important you retain those and reuse those. Like the R3, this bike has a plastic tank cover. It's in 3 pieces. I'll be showing you that as we move forward with this project. Here. Four mil. Four mil over here. Is your shoulder very important, just like back here, that you don't just put a fastener in without the spacer, because it'll crush your plastics and crack them. Okay, Now, what you need to do is you need to disengage the plastic pins with the rubber grommets. Kind of wiggling and pulling. Same thing back here. So, the black piece stays attached to the blue piece. There's one pin here at the very back. Here's the grommet right here. There's one up here at the front. The grommet for that is right over here. That piece kind of looks like you would disassemble it, but you don't. The two halves stay together. Come over here and repeat the same process. Nice and easy. Off it comes. Now we're going to go up to the front of the motorcycle and we're going to remove the mirrors. .10 millimeter socket on a quarter drive ratchet. This is pretty basic here. Just gonna slide the nuts on there to hold them in place. Not lose them. Come over and do the other side. Got a lot of cool stuff on the way, a lot of cool stuff here already. We have a lot of great vendors that we work with here. Proud to offer their parts, and it was good to see everyone really excited for this project. It's been a hot minute since we've done a bike, and these have been pretty successful for us over the years. It gives people a great baseline to service their own bike and tackle some of their own projects that they might otherwise not want to tackle. Okay. Off are your mirrors. To remove the nose piece, there is a fastener right here. Just so you know, this could be Phillips, this could be 4mm internal hex. There's the length. Go on the other side, remove that one. Just a mirror image of what we already showed you. Okay, now we're going to raise the bike back up, and there is a little panel right under the front fairing right here. This is an independent piece that we need to pull off. There are a couple of clips. Plastic clips that have a Phillips in the center. These have been pretty good to me, but you need to know, they're not always nice. Sometimes these things are just flat out horrid to try and get out of there. So take those two out, and then there are right here two 4mm internal hex fasteners. You could take the nose off before pulling this panel, but this is just how I chose to do it here. Once you have that fastener out, grab it right here, pull forward like so. Now, grab it here by the ears, and what you want to do is you want to kind of get down here and slide your fingers in between the black piece and your blue plastic. I'll show you what you're doing. There's two rubber grommets that these engage with right here, okay? And then there are these plastic clips right down here at the very bottom of that panel. Okay, that's how you remove that one. Now we have these little panels right here on the sides of the tank. There are pins with a push-in center, two of them up here at the front. It's funny how some of those release so easy and others, like, you gotta put all this pressure on them. Like that one. I was like, no, uh-uh. That one was happy in there. It's crazy. Out it comes. Now we have right over here. You want to slide over here real quick, Lucas. This is a silver 4mm internal hex. Important to note, there's a little plastic washer behind it. Anywhere where they have painted surfaces and it's external, right, where you don't want to scratch the paint, you're going to have a plastic washer behind the fastener itself. Now grab this panel and slide forward. Off she comes. Go over to the other side. All right, get your pins out. We got the 1 4mm fastener back here. Really pretty close to having this all removed. Take that out. Slide it forward, off it comes. Now we're ready to start removing the side fairings on the bike. Four mil internal hex. There is an outside possibility in some of the locations you might see a Phillips where I'm seeing a hex. Okay. There is a plastic pin with a rubber grommet right here. See that? This little panel comes right off after that. Now for your side fairing, okay. You've got a 4mm internal hex right back here. We already removed the plastic clips that hold this to the inner closeout panel. It's important to note that. It's important to make sure you've gotten that done as well. Take that fastener out. Come up here. Release this wiring harness from where it's captured. Release that. Now, there is one push pin right here. Okay, I don't know if it's gonna be able to get that or not, but push in on the center, release. Grab the fairing, and I want you to pull outward and you're gonna hear a clip. Once you hear that one release, I want you to then kind of work this forward, like so. You have a wiring harness retainer right here. Slide your harness out of that clip. Here is your side panel. Let's take a close look at these two clips. Here's the one that goes in the very front. Here's the one that goes in the side. You need to release the one on the side before you're able to release the one up front. End of the day, this is really a pretty simple procedure. Plastic pin. Wiring harness. Release that. And then you also have that harness retainer up here. Release that. Pull out, push forward, off comes that panel as well. Tank cover. We got one plastic clip here. It's one of those Phillips head style. Once you get that off, got a couple of 4mm internal hex. Got one here all the way at the front. Let's see, it's got a silver head. And here in the back, these do not have plastic washers behind them because you do not see this. When the trim is all in place, none of that surface is visible. Here is a larger head, 4mm internal hex. Once you get these fasteners off, show you how to remove the right half. Kind of grab it right here, and you're kind of pulling out and up at the same time. Take your time here, you know, put a little pressure on it in different ways. Get it to release. Really pretty simple. If it's resisting too much, you know, if it requires too much pressure, something's wrong. You know, don't go cracking the cover. Here. And same deal. Roll this thing off like so. Center of the cover. Pretty basic. Got four 10mm hex head. Let's go ahead and lift that straight off. When we come back, we'll take off the light assembly up front. We're gonna remove the front light assembly front support. You have a little wiring harness retainer right here. I'm gonna have to get my trim clip tool. It's down here. Slide that in here. Work that loose. Then you have the wiring connector here. Pull that back, like so. 4 mil internal hex fasteners. There are two on each side. Got one up top here. Lucas is trying to look for a good spot to get you guys an angle on this. These videos are hard to shoot. They're hard to shoot, and part of it is we like to show you guys all of it and not just all that fast forward bullshit. Hey, look at how fast we got it done. It's amazing. You know, we try to show you every step of the project. And this year, you know, we're changing a couple things around. Like leading off with showing you the tools that I use. People have asked for that. Just prove that we listen. We listen to the stuff that you say. And, you know, we've added that in. I think that's going to be pretty beneficial for some people. I know some techs will use power tools when they remove body fasteners like this. I won't. I just don't. If you come to the track and see me working on Max's bike, you're going to see me with T-handles on the bodywork all the time. I really don't use power tools very much. But if that's something that you want to do, it's your bike. I mean, you want to use a Makita or a DeWalt or something, or knock yourself out. Just keep in mind how small all these fasteners are. This is where that ball type, like, look at that angle that I got that working on. That's pretty sweet. Really helpful. I think that's if you're going to work on your own bike, that's one of the things you should have in the toolbox. Motion. I have a little Motion Pro set. Actually, somebody lost my 5mm. Damn it. To get another one, but okay. Now, just kind of give this a good wiggle here. And off that comes. Here is your, right, for the outer lights, okay? The center light is still in place. There's a controller for it. This is as far as we're gonna go with body work. If you're replacing the light or the fender, right? Those things, once you get to this level, they're super, super self-explanatory. When we come back, we'll begin working on the reinstallation. At the end of the day, it is very simple. It is reverse of everything that we just did. I'm gonna say now, because not everyone's gonna go all the way to the end of this video. If you have questions, leave those in the comment section. I answer all that stuff myself. Sometimes we're traveling and I don't get to them for a week, but you can rest assured, I'm gonna get to it. Okay, let's go ahead and put this light assembly and support back on the bike. There are four mounting points, right? You can see they're raised up here. There's a little post. That post needs to slide through the rubber grommet on the fairing stay. You've got two on either side. Let's go ahead and get this lined up. Push that through. We'll go ahead and grab our fasteners. I'm going to use four identical fasteners. They have a washer attached to them. Four internal hex, about that long. While you get the first one started, you're just going to want to kind of support that with your hand so it doesn't end up falling off the bike. I'm using that four internal hex Allen head here with a, it's Got that ball type on the end so you can kind of use it at an angle. That is a Motion Pro kit. I do believe we have those on the website in the Motion Pro category. Something worth adding to the toolbox for sure. Okay, now we're going to go ahead and we're going to plug in the lights that are attached to that trim panel. And there's a little anchor point over here for the harness. You're going to find that a mirror image on either side. Let's go ahead and get those both in there. All right, that part is done. Here's that front fairing. You got these two pins that need to push into the rubber grommets here. You have your two clips that are going to line up right here at the bottom. And then we have a couple of fasteners that we took out, as well as the mirrors that will help hold this all together. Like so, you just heard that clip in. And with the mirror, there is the rubber that goes around the bushing. You want to make sure that you don't trap the rubber under this and pin it like that. So you want to kind of lift up on it and make sure that the rubber is not being compressed at all. Go ahead and grab the mirrors, throw those back on. A lot of pieces to this bodywork kit. These are 10 millimeter hex. The other side is just a complete mirror image. Okay, now we're gonna go ahead and get that fuel tank cover put back on. It's pretty simple here. You got your four 10 millimeter external hex shouldered fasteners. Once you get the center installed, then you can get the side panels for the tank cover put back on. This video is going to end up being really long, just kind of is what it is. This is a big job. And what a lot of riders will probably do is just fast forward through and go to the sections that are applicable to the task they have before them. All right, now the side of the tank cover. Obviously a little more complicated than the center. You have all these tabs, okay? What you wanna do is you wanna take and get them lined up correctly, and then put pressure from the outside in. You want to support the centerpiece when you're doing that. You'll know when you've got it in a position. You don't have to push very hard. You can see I really didn't put a lot of force behind that. You've got the plastic clip that goes up here towards the front. We should give you a good look at that. I don't think he's gonna capture that on camera right now. That goes right down here, and that tab, like I said earlier in the video, I think we gave you guys a really good look at what that was. And we'll show you, of course, on the other side. You're gonna use this fastener here at the back. You don't need a lot of torque on these. Want to be really careful not to over torque and damage the cover. That one goes in the forwardmost position. Okay, let's go ahead and reassemble our tail section. There's the plastic clip. There's the forwardmost one. Here's your rubber grommets. Go ahead and slide this into position. Get those to lock in like so. We'll go to the other side. Do the same thing. Slides over that like so. Here's your fasteners that we took out that have the spacer. Make sure the spacer finds its way back in there. Wrong one. Being able to remove and reinstall the bodywork is kind of like the keys to the kingdom when it comes to doing your own projects. If you can do this, you can do a lot of the modifications that riders like to do to their bikes, right? Fender eliminators, turn signals, shit like that, exhaust, maintenance items, oil change, those things. You know, you have to be able to do this part first. Snug those four up. And then we'll get this. This fastener in, it's a 4 mil internal hex. And then you need to grab this little panel here, and you want to make sure that you slide it over the taillight so it grabs the end of your taillight and has that captured right there. Make sure it's in. Grab another one of these shorties, 4 mil internal hex. Plastic clips. It's going right there. These shouldered fasteners go right here. Those 10 millimeter hex. I'm gonna hit your microphone there. There we go. Four mil internal hex. Go ahead and raise the bike up. When we come back, we'll be putting the closeout panel down there on the bottom of the tail section. Okay, you see the tabs that are part of this panel. You wanna make sure you get those lined up like so. Push it up into place. Our poltergeist bike lift. Decided to move a little on its own. clips back in there. Got two back here just underneath the tail light. Alrighty, held on by a few different fasteners. Got these 4mm internal hex, one up here at the front. Like so, once again, not a lot of torque. Got one here at the back. And then we have a shouldered fastener back here. It's gonna have a 5mm internal hex. And we'll go over to the other side. The other panel installed. Now there's also clips. Got one right here. And then there is another one that you access from underneath. See it come through right there. Like so. Okay, now let's go ahead and install the panel on the other side. That is, of course, after Lucas stepped on the pedal for the bike lift and sent the bike to the moon. Go ahead and get those clips lined up with your rubber grommets. Make sure that slides over like so. And then back here too, there is a little locating post. You want to make sure it goes through that hole before you put your fastener in. You don't want to break anything off. Back here. Internal hex up front. Once again, not a lot of torque. This one has a 5 internal. Two clips. Now we're ready for our rider seat. Want to make sure this slot lines up with that tab. Front here. We've got two fasteners here at the back. Or a 5mm internal hex. Like so. Panel back here. These tabs interact with these tabs. Slide it down into position and kind of gauge the other tabs up here. Two more clips. Passenger seat. I want to make sure this tab slides into that slot. Bang that down, secure it into place, and now we'll be ready to put the side fairings on. Okay, start over here on the brake side. Go ahead and plug in your electrical connector like so. The tabs up here on the front of this side fairing. You're going to begin with the one that faces directly towards the rear of the bike. Line it up like so, pull back, push in on the one on the side right there. It'll support itself from here, and we'll go over and grab the fork T-handle that I forgot. Put the fastener here in the back. This will hold it all in place for us. You want to make sure that your spacer is in that rubber grommet. Didn't work its way out of there. We do need to secure the wiring harness too. Do that in two spots. Spot one is right here. Push that back up and through like so. And then there is a little retainer for the harness where it goes up to the light in the front up here. Once you have the whole side fairing secured, make sure you put in this little plastic clip right there. Very similar procedure on the other side. Get that other front fairing, side fairing installed. Okay, same deal, super basic. Let's start off with that forward most clip. One on the side. Let's go ahead and plug in our harness. Push that up and through and secure it. You want to grab the harness for the light up front here too. Weave that through its retainer, like so. From here to the back, let's put that fastener in. Okay, once you have the side fairing secured, you want to make sure you install this plastic clip up here in the front where it meets that support. Now you need to make sure to get the clips in the side of the panel. These are the plastic clips that have the Phillips center. Everything lined up. Push down, lock into place. Got to do that on both sides. Like so. Now we're ready to install the panels on the side of the fuel tank. Okay, now we're going to install the panels here on the side of the fuel tank and up towards the front. Start off with a little black one. You've got your plastic pin here. It's got to go through that rubber grommet. Dip that in. Going to secure it into position with these two fasteners. They're black in color, about that length. 4 mil internal hex. Once you've got that one secured, grab the painted panel. This one needs to slide from front to back to lock into position. So first lay it in there all the way forward, a little downward pressure on it, and then slide back. Then kind of go around it and make sure that it's locked in everywhere, which it is. You got three plastic pins, two go up here in the front. One goes right here in the forwardmost corner of the fuel tank cover. Silver in color with a plastic washer. Use that to secure the painted panel. Don't need a ton of torque there. Line over the other side. Same procedure. Dip that into position. Same two fasteners. Like so. Let's grab this panel. Start with it kind of forward, then push back. I want to check it, make sure everything's interlocked. Good to go. Put your plastic clips in there. One up here in the corner. And then, of course, that fastener right there on the side. Put in the fasteners that secure the front fairing to the support that it is attached to. And once we've done that, we're ready to raise the table and install the lower pieces of the fairings. We're really getting close to the end of this project. Okay, now you want to install the lowermost fairings. That slides over that stud like so. Let's go ahead and get our spacers, our fasteners back here. Got one here just in front of the kickstand, and there'll be one just behind it. Make sure you get your spacers in there. Let's go through the grommet. Like so. Got a 10 mil nut, goes right here. You want to make sure that your top hat spacer is installed in there, which this one still is. Now we'll go over to the other side. And we're going to install this one. First thing you have to do is get this all lined up here. Grab this fastener with that top hat spacer. Make sure you got that slid through the grommet. Tighten all this up. Now we're ready for the two mid fairings on both sides. Okay, the mid over on the brake side, there's this little locator post. At the end of the day, not all of these are gonna survive, I'm gonna tell you that right now, okay? Wouldn't be the end of the world if that were gone, but still you wanna try and preserve it. It needs to go through the little hole you see in the side fairing there. So you want to start with that. You want to start by getting that into position and then work from front to back to get the clips snapped in. If you have trouble with that and you happen to destroy it, you're gonna be fine. Once again, very little torque. That's kind of securing everything. It allows me to put just a little bit more pressure on there to get the other ones to engage. Like so. This tab needs to slide into the groove right there. And then there is a grommet. I don't know if you can capture that right or not, Lucas, right here. Got to push that tab through that grommet. That's going to hold that fairing in place now. From here, you can install this pin on the one side. It's going to hold that into position. You can also put the two bolts in to finish securing the fairing. You got one here at the back. And you have another one right up here. Now I'll go over to the other side and get that side attached to the bike. Okay, just like we showed you on the other side, there's that little locator post. It corresponds with a hole here. We want to try and get that lined up first. Make sure those are all engaged like that. Pop that in. I want to make sure that tongue is lined up to go through the slot. And push the clip through the rubber grommet. Got your bolt back here, 4 mil. Internal hex. Like so. A little inward pressure here. Slide that clip through the corresponding hole. And secure it. There are two of these that go from the inner panel to that mid fairing. Get that in there. Same thing on the other side. Like so. Now we need to slide this little panel and this slides front to back. Kind of holds itself in there. Got a couple of clips. These are the ones with the Phillips center. Those locked into position. To fasteners up front. Make sure you get these back in there. These are four internal hex. And go ahead and snug those down. Okay, ladies and gents, well, that's video number one. This is a really long one. This is a dry one. And just so you guys know, we're doing this one only for you. I'm not even trying to sell you any parts in this one. But this is an important one. You need to be able to get all those pieces off and back on to do the projects that many of us want to do to our motorcycles successfully. If anything that you saw here leaves you with an uncomfortable feeling like you're not going to be able to get it done, even if you watch this video, be smart, take your bike to a licensed professional and let them do the work. You've only got two wheels. If one of them falls off, that's going to be a problem. If you have any questions, leave those in the comments section of this video. I'm here to help make your experience with your next project a positive one.